dreams that he'd had in the past. The Psalms, many of the Psalms in the Bible, the worship book of the Bible, the Psalms, they look back oftentimes explaining Israel's history, talking about their freedom from slavery, talking about what that meant, revealing God's work through all of that, that freedom, redemption that they experienced, essentially. And it's so important that those prophetic voices raised up, that they were raised up by God, and that they spoke so that the people could actually understand their identity. Because if you don't understand your past, you don't understand why something's happened to you, you can draw the wrong conclusions about your identity and who you are. And so the prophets were sent by God, people with messages by God recorded in Scripture over thousands of years, in part to identify and explain and give meaning to what had happened already in the past, to look back and say, this is what is happening, to give identity. But the other reason the prophet spoke about the past is to confront sin. For there to be peace, for Jesus to be the peacemaker, to bring peace on earth, you have to first confront the sins of the past. Every generation needs this, every individual needs this, and this is the work of prophets, is to point out the destructive things that have happened in the past and to call people back to repentance. Jesus, and the Bible's telling us Jesus is the voice behind all of those voices. And the reason it matters so much is because if we don't see it this way, then really the Bible remains kind of almost dead to us. But once we see the voice, the voice of Jesus is coming through on every page, it makes it alive to us.
You know what feels really good? Hitting that beautiful like button. It's just sitting right there, all alone, with nothing to do. Help it live to its fullest potential. You know what else feels really good? Embracing that subscribe button. It's like a puppy begging for attention. Just showing it a little bit of love goes a long way. Like and subscribe.